Hello, I'm Brian McNamara. I'm a distinguished engineer at Capital One, where I accelerate serverless adoption across the enterprise. Now, Capital One operates within AWS at a massive scale. We run thousands of accounts, and within those are tens of thousands of Lambda functions. Don't forget, Capital One is a bank, tightly regulated. We have to create controls around how we operate all these accounts to be in compliance. What do you do when you need to manage thousands of Lambda functions? You create standards. Setting development and compliance standards is imperative. We launched our Serverless Center of Excellence, or COE, to support our cloud adoption and modernization and drive serverless strategy, enablement, and support. Our COE defines best practices and standards for leveraging serverless architecture at scale, and today, I'm going to share some of those with you. At Capital One, we have thousands of engineers across multiple lines of business. So while I'm over in our retail line of business, which creates all the software that you might use as a customer to interact with the bank, there are engineers over in the credit card line of business and others in risk and so on. If we don't engage the other lines of business, we risk making silo decisions that could impact the whole enterprise. Decisions that impact the entire enterprise should be collaborative. Our Serverless Center of Excellence team includes representatives from each line of business who collaborate to establish best practices for serverless at scale. We not only get rid of silo decisions, but our COE reduces tech debt. Our team meets regularly to discuss and create guidance on all kinds of enterprise issues, such as Lambda default settings, runtime deprecation processes, and training. Needless to say, we've learned a lot from our serverless journey. Here are a few key takeaways. Leverage industry standard tools, particularly those designed for serverless, and empower developers to be productive and iterate quickly. Tools like AWS Serverless Application Model, or SAM, help streamline development processes. AWS SAM has a command line interface that allows you to build and iterate locally without needing to deploy to the cloud. Next, shift the unit of scale away from request per second to concurrency, and make sure your developers understand this new paradigm. This will probably be a new concept to your team, so you'll want to make sure that your developers understand how to calculate concurrency. Concurrency equals the average request per second times the average request duration in seconds. Everything is measured in seconds. Let's look at an example. Say you have a Lambda-backed API with 100 RPS. Let's assume it runs your function for an average of 500 milliseconds, or half a second. 100 times 0.5 equals 50. It's going to consume 50 units of concurrency. How about one more example? RPS starts at 100, but your durations are now higher. 2 seconds. That's 100 times 2, so now you need 200 units of concurrency to service this use case. Also, keep in mind that if you're working in Lambda, the goal is to drive the invocation times down and minimize the amount of consumed concurrency. There's a limit to the amount of concurrency available per account per region. Another lesson we learned is to embrace a multi-account strategy where each team, or each team and environment, has their own AWS account. Opt for many small accounts over a few large ones. Why is having a multiple of smaller accounts better than a few large accounts? Because this strategy allows you to limit blast radius and allows teams to scale usage with fewer constraints. AWS organizations makes governance and management of these small accounts a lot easier. Also, set development standards. Establish clear standards, like the use of aliases and versions, to ensure consistency across functions, and be sure to enforce these standards. For example, we require a live traffic alias to be the target for all Lambda functions. This ensures that we understand how all Lambda functions are executed. We also require all functions to be deployed using versions to ensure consistency and prevent accidental changes. Through our Center of Excellence, we've identified a list of recommended practices that come from a lot of testing and real-world experience. I'd like to touch on a few more really quickly before we wrap up. 1. Optimize memory. Memory is the one setting that has a big effect on function performance and cost, so getting it right is important. Use tools like AWS Lambda Power Tuner to optimize memory allocation. 2. Optimize for Lambda's cold and warm lifecycle. This includes not only code, but also packaging and configuration optimizations. And 3. Understand observability signals. The need to observe your Lambda applications doesn't change, but the tools and techniques might. keep an eye on key metrics to ensure optimal performance and resource utilization. That's just to name a few. If you're interested in more of our learnings, check out my team's serverless blogs on CapitalOne.com/tech. Feel free to borrow from these best practices if you and your team are also seeking to leverage the potential of serverless computing within a massive scale environment. Thank you for your time.